Howdy folks, and welcome back to World of Warships with Rear Admiral Jingles, and today we're going to be taking a look at some of the new French cruisers coming soon to World of Warships near you. I do apologise for the French music playing in the background. Unfortunately, it's the war, you see. No, really, it is. In 1994, the French government passed a law that required French radio stations, by law, to have at least 40% of their music French cultural music. Just like this. Well, that doesn't sound so bad, Jingles. Well, yeah, but what if you're a radio station that specialises in rock and roll or Latin music? Yeah, Radio Latina, now featuring the greatest hits of Sacha Distel. Of course, what the French radio stations did was they just picked the same 10 boring 1940s French ballads, and any time they were supposed to be playing French music, they just played those. Over and over and over and over. And so in 2016, the French government decided that they would relax the restrictions on playing non-French music, and now they're only required to play 35% of their playlists from artists other than French artists. And if you specialise in foreign music, it's now only 15%, so you still get Sacha Distel on Radio Latina in France, but hey, what are you going to do? What's all this got to do with World of Warships, Jingles? Oh, nothing, I just thought it was funny. Anyway, French cruisers are coming to World of Warships. Now, what I don't want to do in this video is dwell on the statistics of these ships, because, well, as you can see by the work-in-progress branding, which Wargaming were insistent that we include, all of this is very much subject to change. Nevertheless, if you do want to see the current subject to change detailed stats of these ships, you can always pause the video and have a good look, because the stats are there on display. All I am going to be doing, however, is giving you a sort of summary, the cliff notes of each of these ships. I'm going to be splitting this French cruiser preview into two videos. Today we're going to be looking at the tier 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and then later on in the week we'll be taking a look at the tier 7, 8, 9 and 10. And just to make sure you have plenty of advance warning, I will be absolutely butchering the pronunciation of these French cruiser names, because I'm English, and that's just what we do. We're going to begin, as is entirely logical, with the Tier 1. I really don't know how to pronounce this. The Bougainville? Whatever. I'm going to call it Bob. Bob is an aviso. What the hell's an aviso? Well, it's a Spanish and Portuguese term that means advice, or notice, or dispatch. And that's basically what these ships were originally designed for. In the French, Spanish and Portuguese navies, they were used to carry orders and information to the far-flung reaches of the various different colonial empires. Of course, the invention of the telegraph and radio soon put pay to that. But these ships were still used to patrol the various different empires. Nowadays, the term aviso, at least in naval practice, is used to describe any class of ship that's bigger than a patrol boat, but smaller than a corvette. And Bob here, the French Tier 1, is very well armed for a Tier 1 cruiser. It has 139mm guns, although it does only have three of them. The second biggest guns of any of the Tier 1 cruisers, second only to the USS Erie with its 152mm guns. Life is not particularly complicated in this little Tier 1 French cruiser. It only fires high explosive ammunition, and it only has one consumable, and that's the damage control party. So what can you expect with the other French cruisers from playing Bob here at Tier 1. To be completely truthful, not an awful lot. He's not especially representative of the other French ships. For a start, he's bloody slow, which makes him a very easy victim for friendly ramming from other players on your team who are very anxious to see the new French ships. This was the first time this happened to me while I was playtesting the French ships, and it is certainly not going to be the last. The guns are not bad, however, and that is representative of the other French cruisers. The guns are also a little bit bigger than you might expect to see on other ships of the same type and tier. And again, in certain respects, that is also quite representative of the subsequent French cruisers. Most cruisers and battleships of other nations, for example, they are fairly standard in the calibers of guns that they come equipped with. The Germans like to be a bit funny with their 11-inch guns on their battleships and their 150mm guns on their cruisers, but generally speaking, your light cruisers tend to be equipped with 6-inch guns, your heavy cruisers tend to be equipped with 8-inch guns, and your battleships come with your 14, 15, 16, and if you're the Yamato, 18-inch guns. The French, however, the calibers of the guns equipped on these cruisers are all over the place, beginning down here at Tier 1. with 139mm. And 139mm is a very, very important number when it comes to the caliber of a gun, because the Tier 2 skill, basic firing training, 139mm of caliber is the maximum size of the gun barrel where you can still get the most benefit from the basic firing training skill. The USS Erie might look big and clever with its 152mm guns at Tier 1, but that means it doesn't get the 10% faster reload that you get on guns of 139mm and below. Bob here does get it, which means that while he may only have three of these 139mm guns, they are fairly hard hitting. They're fairly accurate, and thanks to getting the full benefit from the basic firing training skill, they're also pretty fast firing. So even if you do come across a USS Erie, for example, and he does have bigger guns than you, and he does have more of them, your DPM is still very, very competitive. So that's the French Tier 1, and that's quite enough Tier 1 seal clubbing in co-op battle for now. Let's move on to the Tier 2. At Tier 2, we have a ship that only its mother could love. This is not an attractive ship at all. This is the Jurien, or to give it its full title, the Jurien de la Gravière. It's a protected cruiser, similar to the St. Louis, for example. It's not as tough as the St. Louis, but it does have up to 55mm of Citadel armour. And those weird gun calibers continue at Tier 2. In Tier 1, they had 139mm guns, and at Tier 2, the Jurien has 165mm guns. It has eight of them, and only two of them are situated in turrets, one at the front, one at the back. This is a kind of good news, bad news situation with the Jurien, because those turrets, they don't turn particularly quickly. It takes them 18 seconds to traverse 180 degrees from port to starboard. The other six of the 165mm guns are situated in barbettes, three on the port side, three on the starboard side. So the fact that the gun turrets up front and to the rear don't turn particularly quickly isn't that much of an issue, because only two of the guns are in turrets. The rest are going to be facing down whichever side of the ship happens to be pointed towards the enemy. And with careful angling, you can get up to five of these guns firing at a target at the same time. And they are 165mm guns, and they do pack quite a punch. They also seem to be pretty accurate. And this is something else that I've noticed, and that I really like about the French cruisers, because, well, call me a bluff on traditionalist, but I do like hitting targets that I'm aiming at. And that's not something that you can always guarantee when you're sailing ships of other nations. And yet I do consistently seem to be able to hit the targets that I'm firing at when I'm sailing these French cruisers, and I don't think it's because I suddenly became a much, much better shot overnight. The thing is, however, when you look at the actual dispersion figures for these guns, I mean, they are pretty accurate, but they're not the most accurate. They're not that much better than a lot of the other ships, and some of the other ships at each tier. The Auber, for example, at Tier 6, has better dispersion than the French Tier 6 cruiser. And yet, I still seem to be hitting the target more in the French cruisers than I am in cruisers of other nations. Now, it's not just the dispersion that's a factor there. You also have the shell velocity, and the velocity of the shells does seem to be pretty good. In most cases, it's well over 800 meters per second when you're firing both armor-piercing and high-explosive. But what I think may be going on here is that the French cruisers seem to have pretty good sigma values, and what that means is we're talking about the vertical dispersion of the shots. As you can see there, pretty much every one of the shots that I fired at that destroyer, with the exception of one shot that went high, all seem to be more or less on target. And when you're shooting at the broad side of a target like that, vertical dispersion is your biggest enemy, because shots that go left or right are still going to hit the ship, but shots that go high or low are going to miss. And these ships don't really seem to miss that much. Another very welcoming feature of these French cruisers is that the guns always have at least adequate range, and in some cases exceptionally good range to go with that good accuracy. The surface detection range of these ships, and while some of them aren't particularly sneaky, the surface detection range is always less than the maximum range of the guns, even without the upgraded fire control systems on stock ships. Now, the window that you have between being able to fire at a target and being detected by a target isn't always great. Here on the Jurien, for example, at Tier 2, the guns have a range of 10.3 kilometers and will be spotted, providing you're not firing those guns, at a range of 9 kilometers. But that little window of opportunity is at least there that should, providing you're careful, allow you to get the first shot off before you are inevitably detected. It's not something you can say of ships of all other nations. One peculiar feature of the Jurien is that it does not have any secondaries at all, none. Those 865mm guns are all that it has. They're the biggest guns of any of the Tier 2 cruisers. Bigger than the Chickama, bigger than the Chester, way bigger than the Novik, even bigger than the Weymouth. And they do pack quite a punch. The initial shell velocity is, however, kind of slow. 770 meters per second. Maybe the slowest of the French cruisers. Having said that, though, it's a Tier 2 ship, and you're not going to be engaging targets at ranges of much more than 10 kilometers anyway, so the initial shell velocity isn't that much of an issue. The Jurion does not get torpedoes, of course. If it did, it would be completely overpowered, and ships like the Nassau here just wouldn't stand a chance. None of the other Tier 2 cruisers get torpedoes, not even the Japanese Chickama at Tier 2. However, just because your ship doesn't come equipped with torpedoes does not mean you cannot use your ship as a torpedo, particularly when the match is in the bag and there's only one ship left on the enemy team. Vive la France! Totally worth it. Yeah, I like the Jurion. Despite the lack of secondaries, despite the lack of speed, this is a very, very good Tier 2 cruiser. I like it a lot. This may even be my new favourite Tier 2 cruiser, and if you realised how much I like the Emden, you'd realise how much it cost me to say that about a French ship. So, anyway, moving on. Tier 3. This is the Friant, and I'm probably butchering the pronunciation of that one, so we're going to call this ship Fred. Fred here is the French Tier 3 cruiser, and he is highly unusual, because unlike every other Tier 3 cruiser in the game, all of his main battery guns are in turrets. 8 guns, 2 per turret, 2 turrets up front, 2 turrets to the rear, and they're super firing turrets. Again, highly unusual down here at Tier 3, because what that means is that unlike every other Tier 3 cruiser in the game, Fred can fire all 8 of his guns at the same target if he so chooses. Down here at Tier 3, young Fred exemplifies what you can expect of the rest of the French cruisers, all the way up to Tier 10. He's pretty quick. While he's no speed demon, he's certainly not slow. He will reach 30 knots very, very easily. He's got a powerful engine, accelerates quickly, even with the rudder hard over to port or starboard. He's not overly endowed with armour, and his guns are very nice. Oh yes, and he gets torpedoes. Now, they're not fantastic torpedoes, but he does get a lot of them. They have a 6 kilometre range, they're kind of slow, but he's got 4 launchers, 2 in either side, and the firing arcs are very, very good. Each of those 2 launchers will put 3 torpedoes in the water, so it can fire 6 torpedoes to either side. And again, that 6 kilometre range isn't too bad. Fred's anti-aircraft guns, however, are a bit of a mixed bag. On the plus side, at least Fred has some anti-aircraft guns. That's not something that you can say of every Tier 3 cruiser in the game, but he's a Tier 3 cruiser. Carriers start at Tier 4, so those are Tier 4 carrier dive bombers, and these anti-aircraft guns are completely inadequate for the task. Also, like the Jurion at Tier 2, Fred at Tier 3 does not have any secondary guns, but what he does have are 8 fast-firing and accurate and high-velocity 139mm main battery guns in 4 super-firing turrets. These high-explosive shells leave the barrel at 840 meters per second, the armour-piercing 790 meters per second, which is still not bad. And once again, while playing this ship, I was very impressed at how consistently accurate the shots were. Very few of them deviated too far from the point of aim. And once again, I was very surprised when I saw that the actual dispersion of these guns isn't significantly better or worse than anybody else at the same tier. And yet, I'm hitting the target more often than not when I fire these guns. Again, there are a number of factors that play into that. The very good velocity of the high explosive shells that I'm pummeling this G101 with, 840 meters per second, especially at this kind of range. And his engine's been knocked out, so it's not like he's really avoiding my shots. But, having said that, how many times have you been in exactly this sort of situation with a destroyer, sit and duck, close range, engine's knocked out, and your shots still miss? They go high, they go low, they go long, they fall short. And yes, my own team are trying to torpedo me. So I clear the barrels of the high explosive and load the armour piercing for the citadels that this Caledon ordered. I like this ship. I like the Jurion at Tier 2, and I really like Fred here at Tier 3. This is a good ship. It is not without its weaknesses, however. And the weaknesses, while it's not the firepower, which is good, It's not the accuracy, which is good. It's not the speed, which is adequate, but it's the armor, because Fred is easily the worst armored cruiser in World of Warships. Fred has worse armor than the Caledon that I just scored multiple citadels on. In fact, there are destroyers in this game that have better armor than this French cruiser. And I'm not talking about Russian destroyers, right? American destroyers have better armor than this ship. The Farragut has better armor than this ship. So before you get too carried away about Fred's performance, just remember, anything Fred can do to you, you can do to him. Having said that, though, I mean, the 6mm of bow armor and the, I think, 13mm of belt armor plating on this ship may seem like a bit of a curse, but if a battleship is shooting at you, and Fred's tier 3, so he's only going to have tier 4 battleships shooting at him, but tier 4 battleships can come with 14-inch guns. Armor piercing from a 14-inch gun is going to completely over-penetrate this ship, causing minimal damage. If the stats on this ship don't change too much, and I hope they don't because I do think it's a very enjoyable ship, the best way to deal with one of these things if you see them is to just think of it as a very big Russian destroyer. Because it's got worse armor than Russian destroyers. And what do you do when you see a Russian destroyer? You pummel him with high explosive. Fred has something that Russian destroyers don't have. Fred has a citadel. You will score citadels on this ship with high explosive. Treat it like a very, very big and obvious destroyer, and you probably won't go too far wrong. Hold on, comedy moment coming here. Friendly destroyer up ahead managed to miss a stationary Langley with his own torpedoes while at the same time sailing into the Langley's torpedoes. Right, fine, I'll kill him. Obviously, you need a job doing properly. You call in the French. Wait, did I really say that? don't worry, we'll edit that bit out. So, yeah, tier 3. Good ship. Like it a lot. What's at tier 4? At tier 4, we have another French cruiser with a name that's just trying too hard. This is the Duguay-Trouin, I think, but I'm just going to call it the DT. Now, this ship is armed with 8 155mm guns. And it's here at tier 4 where you first run into one of the other significant characteristics of the French cruisers, and that's the slow turning rate of the turrets of the guns. It takes this ship nearly 30 seconds to rotate these turrets 180 degrees from port to starboard. This is really not the kind of ship you want to be getting involved in close range knife fights with multiple other enemy ships, especially enemy ships that are higher tier than you. And so in this game, that's exactly what I'm going to be doing. One other feature of this ship that's a bit of a mixed blessing is, like its predecessor at tier 3, this ship is not overly endowed with an overabundance of armor. It does have better armor than its predecessor at tier 3, but again, this is a sort of good news, bad news situation, because it has just enough belt armor that if you give the side of this ship to an enemy cruiser shooting at you, tier 4 or tier 5 cruiser, it has just enough armor to arm the fuses of the armor-piercing shells to ensure that you take full damage from them when they penetrate your belt and explode inside your citadel. Ouch, that hurt. That was the Emerald over there, I believe. And the Emerald's friends, because myself and this friendly Emerald have just realised we're outnumbered something like 2-1 over here, and it's time for us to get the hell out of here. Of course, just as I was turning to disengage, that's when I took the citadel hits. However, the fact that you do have better armor than your tier 3 predecessor means that you can, if you're angled, bounce shots in a way that the tier 3 just can't really expect to do, as I'm about to demonstrate on my namesake over there, who's angled just about as well as you possibly can be, and as I unload the armor piercing, bounces harmlessly off his belt armor. So, good news, bad news situation. You have just enough armor to arm the shells on armor-piercing ammunition fired at you, but you have enough armor that, providing you're angled, you can at least bounce some of those shots. Also, the firing arc of the torpedoes is fantastic. I don't know if you noticed that. And this is common of all of the French cruisers, at least all of the ones that I've played. And I've played up to tier 8 so far. The firing arcs of the torpedoes is exceptionally good. Now, the torpedoes that we have here at tier 4 are nothing special. 6 kilometer range, which is okay, but they're slow, 57 knots. They do about 10,000 damage on a hit. You do get a fair amount of them, however. Two launchers on each side, each with three torpedo tubes. And pretty soon, you're going to be getting 9 km range torpedoes that travel at 60 knots or faster. This ship does have hard-hitting guns when you've got the right target and the right ammunition loaded, however. Boom! Headshot. Look at that. That's a respectable amount of damage done for a battleship broadside. And this is only a Tier 4 cruiser. Meanwhile, I succumbed to what I can only describe as a sudden rush of shit to the brain as I loaded the high explosive for shooting at the broadside of this Königsberg. Not entirely sure why I did that, but I quickly realised my error. Switched back to the armour-piercing, again, while bouncing shots from him by keeping the bows towards him. Torpedoes are not ready to go, but the guns are. 2 rear turrets, 4 citadels, 4 shots. Didn't quite kill him, but he's dead and I'm not, although I am still burning. Really, really nice if I could put this fire out. You'll note that this ship does come with the catapult fighter consumable, and I do recommend taking the catapult fighter consumable. Your anti-aircraft firepower is not good. And you're a Tier 4 cruiser, you're going to see Tier 4 and Tier 5 aircraft carriers. And if you can't break up the incoming waves of enemy aircraft with your catapult fighter, you're going to get hurt by those dive bombers and torpedo... Well, maybe not so much the torpedo bombers, because this is a pretty fast and manoeuvrable ship. But the dive bombers are going to be an issue. I'm slightly more concerned at the moment, of course, is that Tier 5 battleship. So I'm struggling to get myself into concealment behind this island without exposing too much of the side of the ship to him. And holy shit, did I just shoot an aircraft down? It must have been the catapult fighter. It couldn't have been the anti-aircraft guns. Should be reasonably safe here for the moment. I've managed to get some torpedoes away against that König, and I'm spotted by aircraft. But the König's the... Wow, and I've shot down another aircraft. My catapult fighter really has been busy, hasn't he? My anti-aircraft guns aren't firing. And I did manage to get a torpedo hit on the König. Hooray! Range of these guns, 15 kilometres. Surface detection range, 12.9 kilometres. It's only a Tier 4 cruiser, so you can't fit a concealment module. And I'm only running 3-point captains, so there's no concealment skill on the captain either. These are pretty much the base stats. I'm also not running with any signal flags. I'm basically trying to play these ships with as much of a clean slate as possible without, you know, the kind of extras that you might not have access to or might not wish to expend resources on in every game that you play. You may have also noticed that I'm playing these ships in cooperative battles, so we're playing against the AI. And the reason for that is if you have a look in the top left corner of the screen, you can see that I keep spiking red lag. So I didn't really feel like taking my chances in random battles with a bunch of ships that I had no idea how they were going to handle. Not only that, because we're guaranteed to run into one of these French cruisers, because it's mirror matchmaking in cooperative battles, I get to see how hard they are to take down from the other side of the fence. So, what do I think of the French Tier 4? Well, I like it. It seems to play a lot like a Königsberg or a Kirov. Except the Königsberg and the Kirov are Tier 5, and this isn't. It's Tier 4, and yet it feels like the German and Russian Tier 5 cruisers. And that's no bad thing if you're a Tier 4 cruiser. So what's the actual Tier 5 like? At Tier 5 we have the Emile Bertin. I'm reasonably sure I've at least made a passable stab at the pronunciation of this particular name, so we're going to continue calling this thing Emile. There aren't a huge amount of differences between this ship and its predecessor at Tier 4. The major differences are in the firepower, and they're not huge differences. The ship has 3 turrets, 3 guns per turret. They're 152mm rather than 155mm guns. They have a fast reload of 7.5 seconds and manages to achieve 8 shots per minute from each of the guns. The shell velocity is also very, very nice. The shells leave the gun barrels at 870m per second for both the armor-piercing and the high explosive, so you don't need to re-estimate the ballistics depending on the target that you're shooting at and the ammunition that you have loaded. Rapid-firing 152mm guns, and it's got 9 of them, they're bad news for destroyers, and this ship also has the hydroacoustic surge consumable for spotting those pesky torpedoes or those destroyers lurking inside their smoke screens if you happen to be close enough. Like the Tier 4, it's also pretty quick with a powerful engine, top speed of 35 knots, and a 7.4 second rudder shift time. Also like its predecessor, it's very, very capable of scoring citadels and enemy cruisers at any kind of range that are dumb enough to show you the broadside. Unfortunately, also like its predecessor, it does not have a lot of armour. This is a light cruiser. In fact, this particular cruiser was specifically designed to be as fast and as dangerous as possible. And in order to do that... Oof. How many citadels was that? In order to do that, they had to skimp on the armor. So once again, you have just enough armor to arm the fuses of any armor-piercing shells that hit you at a shallow enough angle to penetrate, ensuring maximum damage. And that is bad news. On the other hand, however, you do have enough armor that, providing you are angled, and you don't have to be angled that much, you can at least expect to bounce similar caliber armor-piercing heading in the other direction. The accuracy of the guns, once again, does seem to be very, very nice, and yet the accuracy of the guns, once again, isn't actually any better than any other ship of the same tier, certainly not the cruisers. Once again, I suspect it's the Sigma ratings of the guns that is better than other nations' cruisers of the same tier. It's back to this Cleveland for the moment, and the Cleveland does have a surprisingly tough belt armor, as you can see there. We didn't have to angle an awful lot for me to be completely unable to penetrate his 127mm of Citadel belt armor. So I switched to the high explosive in anticipation of having to deal with an angled Cleveland, and then of course he turned the other way and I could have Citadeled him again, but well, what are you going to do? Anyway, thanks to the cooperative battle mirror matchmaking, I now get the opportunity to see how my Emil is going to deal with the Emil on the enemy team. Now, I have less than half of my health remaining, and he has almost all of his health. So, remember, I can't expect to penetrate this guy with armor-piercing from the front if he's even slightly angled. And so, in the ultimate twist of irony, just as I've been going on about how accurate these guns are, he comes around the corner, he's not angled really at all, and I miss. And now he is angled, but I've managed to take out one of his guns. Armor-piercing once again loaded, I'm not going to penetrate his bows with AP. And so I raised my sights, knocked out one of his gun turrets, then did it again, knocked out his other forward gun turret. So now he's got no guns that he can fire at me other than the gun at the rear. And the other thing about the Emil that makes it different from the Tier 4 is that it does have very, very good torpedoes with a 9 km range, a speed of 60 knots, and 14,000 damage. So Jingles, what do you think about the Emil Bartan, the French Tier 5? Well, big surprise, I actually quite like this ship as well. How about the Tier 6? Are we going to see any major surprises here? Well, yes and no. According to the official description, by the outbreak of World War II, La Galissonière, which is the French Tier 6, was one of the best light cruisers in the world. Yeah, maybe. Here in World of Warships, I'm not convinced. It's not that this is a bad ship. I mean, as you can see, the torpedo firing arcs are absolutely spectacular on this thing. But, and we'll come on to the torpedoes very, very briefly. The major surprise as far as this ship is concerned is that it really isn't any better than the Tier 5. And in some cases it's worse. Those torpedoes, for example. The Tier 5 only had one launcher on each side. They did have fantastic firing arcs. And those launchers could only fire 3 torpedoes. But they were powerful torpedoes with a 9 km range, a 60 knot speed, and 14,000 damage. And they're the same torpedoes here at Tier 6. 9 km range, 60 knot speed, 14,000 damage. But it can only fire 2 of them from each side, one less than the Emil Bartan at Tier 5. Firepower, pretty much exactly the same as the Emil Bartan at Tier 5. Again, 152mm guns, again, 9 of them arranged in 3 turrets. 2 super firing turrets at the front, 1 turret at the rear. The similarities don't end there. These guns also have an 870 m/s initial muzzle velocity. They also fire 8 rounds per minute with a 7.5 second reload, exactly the same as the Tier 5. None of this is bad, of course. I mean, these are perfectly good stats for a Tier 6 cruiser. It's just that it, well, it all seems like a bit meh after the Tier 5. And in some cases, not just the torpedoes, as we've already seen, which are no better, in fact worse, than the torpedoes on the Tier 5 cruiser, this ship is slower than the Tier 5 cruiser, which can do 35 knots. La Galissonière at Tier 6 can only do 31 knots, so it's slower. It also has a slightly slower rudder shift time, so it's less manoeuvrable. The guns do have 1 km better range, but other than that, they're pretty much identical to the guns on the Emil Bartan at Tier 5. So all these little things kind of add up to an overall experience that just feels a little underwhelming after the Emil Bartan at Tier 5, and yet you have to bear in mind that none of this means it's a bad ship. It is a pretty good ship, it just feels kind of meh after you've played the French Tier 5 cruiser. The guns are just as accurate and just as hard hitting at the right target, like that poor little emerald over there, who's eaten all the citadels. Against the wrong target, however, like that enemy, La Galissonnière, who's only slightly angled 152mm armor piercing, is going to do nothing, because this ship actually has pretty good armor. And that is the single major difference between La Galissonnière and the Emile, not just the Emile Bartin, but pretty much all of the other French cruisers up until now. I do suffer from a little bit of a Jingles moment here, by the way. I'm trying to get my torpedoes away because the first salvo missed, and oops, not quite. I've still got the high explosive loaded. I chew on one of his torpedoes. I fumble the reload. I've still got the high explosive loaded, and it's only now when I think, ah, crap, I need armor piercing. Luckily, the ship does have a fast reload, and I do manage to get some citadels in around about now, just before that guy goes down to a torpedo. And the Jingles moment continues, because I'm sitting here having hammered the R key to activate my damage control, not realizing that it was on cooldown at the time. So I think I've sorted out the flooding, and, well, as you can quite plainly see, nope, Jingles, you scrub, you're still taking flooding damage. Oh, shit. In a couple of seconds, I am going to realize, because I'm taking a look at the paper doll above the compass there and think, hang on, why am I still taking... Oh, crap, I'm still flooding. And finally get around to activating my damage control. One other thing, by the way, that I really should have mentioned before now, and it's not just specific to La Galissonnière, but from Tier 6 and up with La Galissonnière, the French cruisers all get access to what, up until now, has been a destroyer-only consumable, and that's the speed boost, which you can quite clearly see is now active, thanks to the thick, dense black smoke that's been pumped out of my funnels. La Galissonnière is also the first of the French cruisers to get access to the defensive fire cooldown. It does not get a catapult fighter. And its anti-aircraft firepower is not bad. It's no Cleveland, but it's certainly got respectable anti-aircraft firepower. And in combination with the defensive fire cooldown, it's going to cause headaches for any carriers on the enemy team. It's also got better secondaries than the Emile Bartin. It's got exactly twice as many 90mm guns as the Emile does at Tier 5. It's got 8 in total. So there are some differences, certainly, between this ship and its predecessor, than just not immediately obvious. Yes, it's slower. Yes, it's a little bit less maneuverable. Yes, it has one less torpedo that it can fire from each side of the ship. Yes, the guns are pretty much exactly the same, although they do have slightly better range here at Tier 6. But it does have better anti-aircraft guns, beyond any shadow of a doubt. And it is substantially better armoured than any of its predecessors up to this point. Don't let that go to your head, however. I mean, let's not get too carried away. 102mm of citadel armour is pretty good, but this is not a battleship. Don't forget it's a Tier 6 cruiser. There are plenty of other Tier 6 cruisers that have 203mm guns. Hell, there are Tier 5 cruisers that have 203mm guns. You're still going to have to angle this thing carefully and be aware of the direction of all the threats around you to make the most of that fairly substantial belt armour for what is just a cruiser. But there are definite differences between this and the Emile Bartin at Tier 5, and they're not all bad. I mean, yeah, alright, it doesn't have as many torpedoes that it can fire out of each side. Yes, it's slightly slower. Yes, it's slightly less manoeuvrable. But it's a tougher ship. The guns, while they do have very similar characteristics, they do have better range. And they're good guns to begin with, and that's really... If you were to ask me what I thought of the French cruisers, so far, at least, initial impressions are not all of them can take too many in the way of hits, because they are just light cruisers, at least so far. But I do like the guns. I don't know, I see a ship that tends to hit what targets you shoot at, and I just press the like button straight away. This is why I don't play too many battleships in World of Warships. And that is definitely a thing, at least in my experience so far, limited though it may be, of the French cruisers. The guns are very good. The various different caliber baguette launchers that you have on these French cruisers consistently across the board just seem to hit what you aim them at. And that always gets a like from me. So I do, initially, have some very, very good favourable first impressions of the French cruisers. And that's been the Tier 1 to 6. And later on this week, I intend to be showing you the Tier 7, 8, 9 and 10. So, I hope you've enjoyed this preview of the lower tier French cruisers coming soon, no idea when, to a World of Warships near you. and stay tuned for the rest of them coming later this week. In the meantime, as always, take care, and I'll catch you next time.